So in a course on vector calculus, first we have to discuss the concept of a vector. So you usually see vectors as arrows, right? A starting point and an ending point, which is the tip of the arrow. A vector then is a quantity that has a length associated with it and a direction. It points in a specific direction. And in vector calculus, we're mainly going to be talking about three-dimensional space. So it lives in three-dimensional space. But it's not located at any particular position. So this vector, you can move anywhere in space. It's not anchored in any particular spot. So let's talk about, we're going to have three vectors here to discuss. We have a vector A, a vector B, and a vector C. I'm going to use this notation of putting this arrow-like object on top of the vector to show you that this is a vector, okay? Besides vector, we have scalars. Scalars are quantities that only have length, say. Not particularly length, but they're like real numbers. They're just numbers. For instance, a vector could be like the acceleration of a mass or an electric field. And a scalar could be like the mass itself, you know, what is the mass of the object or what is the electric charge of a charged particle. Okay, so these vectors satisfy certain rules of algebra. They commute, so that means the commutative law is A plus B is equal to B plus A. That means you can add vectors, right? And addition is commutative. Addition is also associative. So if you add three vectors, A plus B plus C, if you add B and C first, it's the same as A plus B plus C, but you add A and B first. Okay? That's called the associative law. You can also multiply vectors by scalars. For instance, mass times acceleration is the acceleration vector multiplied by the scalar m, ma, as in Newton's law. How does multiplication by scalar work? Multiplication by a scalar will not change the direction of the vector, but will just change its length. Okay? Scalar multiplication of two vectors, A plus B, is distributive. So that's equal to a scalar times A plus a scalar times B. Okay, so these are the basic properties of algebra associated with vectors. So what I want to show you now is in a picture how one adds vectors, how does one add these quantities, and how does one subtract these quantities, okay? So let's start with the addition of two vectors. So we'll look at A plus B, okay? We can draw the two vectors. I will draw them in the plane of the light board. So let's say this is A, and this one is B, okay? I put them so that their tails are touching. Vector A has a length and a direction. Vector B has a length and a direction. We can move these vectors around to wherever we want in space. The way you do vector addition is you place these vectors head to tail. So if we move this A vector down here, we would get the A vector would look like this. Or if we move this B vector over here, the B vector would look like this. A plus B is the vector that goes from the tail here to the connecting heads here, this vector. So this vector here is A plus B, which is also equal to B plus A, which is why you can get there in two different ways. So A plus B is formed by putting the tail of one vector on the head of the other vector and then drawing the vector that connects the tail to the head. Okay. What about subtracting vectors? So let's look at B minus A. Right? Can draw the same sort of diagram. So this is A. This is B. Okay? So what is B minus A? Well, minus A is just the A vector pointing in the opposite direction. So the minus sign just changes, flips the direction of the A vector. So minus A is going to be looking this way, right? So this is minus A. And then we're all set up to draw a vector from their head to tail now. So we can draw a vector from tail to head. So this vector here will be B minus A. Okay? So how do we say that? The vector B minus A is obtained by putting these two vectors, A and B, tail to tail. But B minus A then will point from the head of vector A to the head of vector B. Okay? Points from the head of vector A to the head of vector B. Okay. So I'm showing you here then that vectors are these objects that have a length and a direction. They satisfy the usual rules of algebra or arithmetic in that it's commutative. A plus B is B plus A. It's associative over addition, and it's distributive with K a scalar. So K A plus B is K A plus KB. I also show you how to add vectors. You add vectors by putting them head to tail. And I also showed you how to subtract vectors. You subtract vectors by flipping the direction of the negative vector so that if you're there tail to tail, then B minus A is the vector which is head to head that points from A, the negative one, to B. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.